Hello everybody, this is Virsha, and today I'm going to show you a new game called Erebos Reborn. It's a card game, a bit like Magic the Gathering, and it was recommended by one of my watchers, and I'm happy to have followed his advice because this game is huge, really huge. So you can play the game in different ways, and today I'm going to just play it in casual mode because we have three lines of adventures. I'll show you just after that. In fact, normal or Iron Man are a bit different, are not really different, because it's just that the game lasts longer, and the more you play, the harder the enemies become. And so first, choose a name, choose an organization, you can have none. I must say I have all the DLCs, and I have downloaded some more from the workshop, for instance the Hag and the Arcana. So a new race and a new class made by the developer. He added them to the workshop. And you have several factions, and today I'm going to play a Fae faction. So I'll ally with the Fae. I will play a Fae. As you can see, I have a lot of things locked. When you play, you get tokens, and you can use the tokens to unlock new races or new class. For now, I played Shadow a lot, as you can see here, there, with 72 of mastery. Human, I played them a bit too. And today, as you can see, I have no mastery in the Fae race, because when you click there, you can see all the cards. The starting deck cards are all the skills, and when you will get more mastery, you will have new cards to add into your deck, so you have the time to learn how it plays. So, a Fae, and I will play it as a Hunter. I already played it a bit, so as you can see, I will try to roleplay it a little. Because you can, there are some small events, even if it's just fighting games. So a Fae Hunter in the forest that tries to defend the nature. So I have chosen a name, an organization, my race, Fae Hunter, as my class. You can see there my summon limit, my minimum deck, number of cards I must have in my deck, my health, my actions. Every card will use several actions. How many action points per turn I got back, and my hand size. 4 is very low, so let's get intellect to 15 to get a hand size of 5. Now as I enter, agility will add a lot to piercing damage, as you can see there. For affinities, the resistances are what they are, resistance. So my affinities for piercing, because I will use a dagger, as you can see there. Dagger makes slashing damage. Oh no, it's not. The Fae short spear makes piercing damage, so slashing and piercing are what I will use a lot for now. So slashing and piercing are behind agility and strength. So let's get more agility. I can get over 80. A bit more strength. I have 2 points left. Can add resistance to get more hit points, which is important. And willpower. No changes, nothing. Charisma, nothing. Intellect, nothing. Resilience, nothing. One more strength, okay, more bludgeoning, not really useful for me, but once you have done that, you choose what kind of game mode you want to try. There is a sandbox mode. If this video has some success and people want to see more, I will try not a normal or Iron Man, because you will have already seen what it can do. Puppeteer will let you see in advance what you will have, so will let you prepare a bit more. But the real interesting thing is there, sandbox and draft is a different kind of way to get your first starting cards, because as a Fae I have some starting cards, and as a Hunter I have also other starting cards. I can preview them at least time, and okay. Let's go for a casual mode, start game. So my action points, my hit points. I can go to see my card collections, and you can add or retrieve cards, for instance, hide from view. There are synergy, I will explain them later. So Hunter Brew, yes, very good, I want more. These two, target practice two. Having more cards is not a good thing, because the less cards you have, the more chance you have to draw the card you want. But for the start, I prefer to have all the cards we can have. I already have a silver dagger, because you can see in the equipment that I have a silver dagger, and every turn I will draw it just before my draw step. It means that I have a hand size of 5, but I will draw first my silver dagger, so I can always use it, and then the 4 remaining cards will be taken from my deck. You can have another weapon, so it is a primary weapon. If I use it, it will replace this one. So slashing damage with silver, and this is piercing bleed, piercing damage. So I prefer piercing damage. So I can change, so it doesn't change there, but on the next turn you see I have another one. I can see the deck builder deck, my skills, I can see them all there, and you can see that I don't have enough mastery to have more. Or my level, the level of my character, to get more cards. Mastery with this as a hunter or as a fae. My mastery can unlock all fae cards up to tier 1. And you can see the archetype there. I love how everything is written there, because I use the verbose mode. So I've talked enough, let's start. You can see, let's start. Last thing, you have there the famous line I talked to you about. So you see every, sometimes it is battles, okay, events, treasures, campfire, things like that, and you have a boss. It is the first boss, and there will be three, after three boss have been beaten, this run will end. Let's start. So I have my facial spear, and I have drawn those four cards, and those are for spider diapontons. I can just fight them by using things. So I see I do piercing damage, I take the card, and I did only one damage, and I make him bleed. Why that? So you can click there to get all the informations. So I roll three damage, three piercing, but the target resisted two piercing damage, as you can see there. And look at there, piercing this spider resists two damage, so three less two, only 1 point of damage. So why not another attack? Instead of taking the card and putting it there, I can right click to use it on the optimal target. If I right click, I will use it on myself. This on the first enemy. This is the first enemy. You can rearrange the in which order you have. It's not very useful now, but you'll see later if I can bewitch people. It is very useful, because if you put the bewitch people in first, they will attack their comrades in first and maybe kill them before they can act. So let's just bloodthirst. I kill it. I did 5 damage, but there is 2, so 3 damage. I got experience. Can see there, I am level 1 hunter, level 1. How many summon, how many rations, and my farthings, how many gold I have. So I can camouflage. Now I have 10 points of concealment, and I will defend 3. You can click on it, and you will have an explanation. It will just prevent 3 points of damage, and you can see there it will do 1, 2, or 3, so he won't be able to do anything to me this turn. The concealment is how percentage chance I have to not be beaten, but it can also be used for some attacks, for sneak attack, a sneak attack, you will use concealment to do a lot more damage. But the card I played before had a synergy. When you play a synergy, you have a next action play this turn, get some things, and the next card, as you can see, the text here will change. I will get less concealment and more damage. So as you can see, I should do no damage at all with this card, but if I use it, I will do 3 to 7. Because I have a piercing 4, and as I do plus 3, it will do from 3 to 7. The calculation taking into account how much piercing we do. We have also some perks, so you can read there what it does. So the Silly Court, you pledge your loyalty to the Silly Court, you gain 3 Sons of Dawn and 2. And now slip one phantasmal web card in your stash, or the Unsilly Quartz, Song of Dusk, Darkness and Fear. I can be tough, more HP and more resilience. Alliance Recruit, my slashing damage and my healing effects increases, and I have one copy of Alliance Recruit. I like this, I want this. So now that I have this, you can see in my equipment I have the Alliance Recruit Amulet. I will equip it, and each turn I will be able to heal a bit of damage. It's very useful at start. The perks, please. And I can Blazing Blades. I can join and advance in either the city or the court. So I pledge my loyalty, but the Blazing Blades. It is a faction, if it's optional, but I can only have one faction which I am allied to, and I have already chosen the Fae faction disciplines. I'm a Fae, but I also have the Fae Alliance. If I choose that, I don't know if I will get this win, so I don't want. Will be a kind one or not so kind one? Let's choose the Silly Court, the kind Fae. And now in my deck, the deck builder, you can see I have new cards I didn't have, so I will add them because they were available in my deck builder, but they are not in my deck. You can see that they have been added. Phantasmal Web, nice. I will explain it later. And Song of Doom, item. What Aether is a custom resource which can be used by other cards, but for the moment I have no more cards using it. But it amplifies air and earth, and I don't need air and earth as I don't do air or earth damage for the moment. So I won't put them into my my deck. So as you can see, the synergy that does a bit of stun. Stun will, you can see now, he will skip in his next turn. He's immobilized. You can see there that he got the damage. Sometimes some enemies resist damage. And camouflage, if I use it, I will do more damage because I have new synergy. But the synergy don't last on the next adventure, the next plot. And now I encounter a grimoire in which I can choose one new card I can add into my deck, so it will be usable. To my stash, I can get card from my stash for 1 AP and then they are used, or I could put them in my hand. I can use it now, but after that the card will be destroyed and it won't go into my deck. Song of Dusk, Nether, Dark Poison, Intuition, Clairvoyance, 2 XP, that's nice XP. and restore 8 AP. That's a very good card once we have a lot of equipment that will reduce how much I got 8 AP per turn, but sometimes I have less. So let's put it into my deck for later turns. So let's see, what does the Song of the Fae? Song of the Fae. One, I can click and see. Custom resources. Okay, it's a custom resource. Amplify piercing. One, amplify. It will give more damage. And once it's used, you lose a bit of the amplify things. I will do earth damage because this card is an earth card. This card is a piercing card, so if you use it, you can see it adds piercing. But this one is nice because it will, it has a chance to fight. If I use the alt key and click, I will get more information. To have more detailed rules. Chain. To also damage a random enemy. Okay. Nice. So let's try on them. And as you can see, I hit both of them. Let's use a short spear. He died. Nice. Every time you use a card, you can see there, look at there, you can see tier 1, level 0, XP, and PTN means potential. The XP is each time you use it, so I can use it now, it's useless, it seems useless, but it gives 1 XP to the card, and if, once it gets more level, the card becomes stronger. So I can't use this card on the enemy, so if I use it, the damage will be done to me. Okay, so I won't use it. And next turn. Oh. The sage offers to train you if you show her that you can survive in the world. So she asks you a question. So tell me, my dear, you meet a group of demons in battle. What do you do? I use the holy light, I fight fire with fire, hit them with silver weapons, I banish them. Yes, demons to banish. Yes, that might work, but only on weak ones. Oh, natural wound, maybe. Song of Death. Okay, into the deck so I can heal myself. For now, it's easy, but after one or two lines, it becomes a lot harder. Cloak of the Woods. Nice. I will get. It is automatic, so it will be used every turn. So instead of getting 8.8 AP per turn, I will only get 7 because 1 will be used by my cloak. I will always have concealment, more resist. That's very nice for Shadow, which uses the concealment. Oh, so add to inventory. And the torch. It's a single turn, I can only have 1 and it's used several times, and it is an animal bane, but I will use this finesse and put it into my stash in case I will need it. So now let's go into the equipment and equip the Cloak of the Woods. And as you can see now, I have an upkeep of 1 and 7 AP per turn. Learn a new combat technique because I am at Campfire, Song of Dusk, Spirit Bane. Echo means it will be used on the next turn. What does Blessed? It's against weak targets. Weak targets, okay. Piercing damage, good. And Spirit Bane. If this target is Spirit, they get plus 15 intense damage. Whoa. Intense damage is a damage that can be reduced. Intense damage is very good. So, please, come on. So I can rest, but not really useful. As you can see, I have almost all my AP and they have very few hit points. As you can see there their allegiance to every factions. You can see there how they will act each turn. They will try to heal themselves if they are too much hurt. But let's do this. just to get more XP and just brew and play five slashing. Okay, she stunned but dead. Oh, the other one too. Nice. And sometimes when they die they have knapsack. And oh, can't use it now. Ah, okay, because it is on enemy. Because of the synergy. Because it does damage, and when you do damage, but there is no enemy. So next turn we will have a new battle. So I can use it now. As you can see there, how many AP it will do. So 0. I still have 30. Elixir Vitality, nice. Alliance Word, nice. I will take it and sell it in the next town. There will be turn. So let's hide from view first. Then okay, I'm taking bleed, but I killed him. And let's study the grimoire. The cards are random each one, so even if you start with the same character, and the same race and class, you will have different things to do. Vulnerable, Dispel Flame, can be nice. Venom, Equine Deal, Lycanthrope Bane. Let's take that. So Nether Goblin, vulnerabilities, resistance, you can see there, sometimes you have vulnerabilities to poison. Okay, let's amplify slashing and have more damage. A double will give me a chance to do more damage. Okay, killed. Okay, I will use it to get more XP with it. And continue. Oh, an animal companion. Open the chest. Amplify piercing, deal piercing damage. That's nice. I like piercing damage. And this one has a durability, it will be destroyed. So I will just sell it. Let's change our equipment. So I use a facial spear. I make them bleed and piercing damage. And just piercing damage, but I amplify piercing if I have other piercing damage. But it is, as you can see, off-end and shield, so I can use the facial spear and the dagger. That's very nice. Oh, so my first boss, as you can see, has more hit points, it does more damage. They are easy to kill, but let's stun them. As you can see, multicast means you will cast it on the people you target and the other one on the left. So we just hide from view, make a song of the fae, and I will do half damage. Oh, what did she have? A light shield, nice, a long spear. Let's take it. Oh, the long spear. But it is a two-handed weapon. Yes, two-handed. So if I use it, I won't be able to use the dagger. But it does 5 to 10 piercing damage. That's huge. 3 to 6 and 4 to 8. I know, those are better. But they use. The problem is that they use two cards. So I have 5, so I have those two. Then 3 other cards from my hand. But it's not a problem. I will camouflage and use my facial spear to kill the enthralled sorceress and enter. As you can see, oh, he flanked me, so I am vulnerable because it means I will take more damage. He should have attacked me, it would have been better for him. But anyway, I don't care. I use my fishing spear, my dagger, my target practice, and my amulet. End of the turn. So as you can see, it's relatively easy for now, but after the third line of actions, as you can see now, we have a boss, or we'll have a campfire, something unexpected, and especially a grimoire and more battles, and they're a tough battle. I don't need anything. If I have too many cards, I can discard them to get more interesting cards. My amulet, as you can see, is drawn after the draw step. It means that I draw the 5 cards I need, then I will draw it, meaning I have 6 cards. I will use that to get more XP. Okay, so 6 points. Sneak attack plus 2 if I have more concealment. I need a lot of concealment. I don't have enough. I have 5. And the dagger. Let's stun them. And kill him. And continue. The fake cloak X ward will protect me from bleeding and things like that. Amplify piercing is nice. Unravel means if at the end of the turn I didn't use the card, I will get this bonus for the next turn. Reaction means if I don't use it when I draw it, if I play any other card, this card will be lost. Synergy focus is very good because it will help me draw one more card. It will discard one card, but one random card, which means usually you use it in the end and it costs 0, so it's very good to have it once you have played everything. You use it to get one more card. Oh, anaconda, beetle, giant beetles. Okay, let's tripwire first. Oh, it's only the first two. Okay. Phantasmal web. I will be able to entangle one who does most damage. Oh no, he resisted. My action's potential is too low to affect them. When you see that, the tier, level, XP, and PTN, as you can see there, the PTN is potential and it must overcome the power of the card, and I don't know what is the power, probably the level, but I'm not sure. Enemy power increases by +1 for each rage counter. Enemy damage threshold is power, use a power to power damage. Ah, okay, their power is their max damage. So you have a power of 5, a power of 4, a power of 4. Okay, nice to understand something now. So let's camouflage and kill that. And I will do 4 to 8 piercing damage, but I will make him bleed. So let's see. It won't be enough. Next turn. I've been envenomed. Envenomed, I lose 3 HP per envenomed status. I can't prevent it and it doesn't care about shields. Okay. So I don't need it, but I will use it to have more experience. And now, what is that? Flying. So once it is flying, I can't target it with things that don't have a ranged value, range. So I can't do anything to it now. Let's just kill the other. And as you can see, I use it, but it does nothing because they are flying. But I use them because it gives me experience. As you can see, my envenomed state made me lose some hit points. So he will be flying for 2 turns now, and I have a ranged card, which is nice. I first hide from view, and I don't know if I have enough piercing. Even if he's flying, I will give him things. No, he doesn't. He doesn't bleed because I know because it is too low. But the bleed would have been useful. I mean, the damage isn't done because they are flying, but you can apply status effect. Level up. I can see that I have now new skills. Perfect Ambush and Unleash. Let's see in the card builder. Unleash. Target companion ally. But I don't usually have. I have only one. I hope I will be able to use it now. I will get more damage because of teamwork and I will get retribution, which is very nice. Let's add some of these cards. And what was perfect ambush? It is a range. Good. Alors, expand concealment. It means I need concealment. I get sneak attack. And blood tribute. I don't know what it does. Blood tribute. What does blood tribute do? Please. Blood tribute. How can I see? Oh. I look at it when it will be useful. Okay. Let's use it for the XP. Next turn. I got more hit points too. Beyond the fog of the lake, you start hearing a beautiful song. It's filled with melancholy, it's filled with peace, it's filled with passion. But most importantly, it's filled with desire. Maybe a nymph? It calls to you and resisting it is becoming increasingly harder and harder as seconds go by. Investigate the song. Yes, but I am a female. Will it work on me, a siren? You follow the song through the shallow part of the lake. Its power over you will spread through. The closer you get, the water reaches your waist, and the song is everywhere at the same time. Your eyes keep looking for the source of the chant, but the fog is too thick for you to discern anything. Suddenly, the music stops, and a thin arm wraps around your neck. It's been a long time since I saw one as young as you. The siren slowly examines you. You try to speak, but you can't seem to utter coherent speech. Her whimsical touch sends shivers down your body, and with every word she speaks, your thoughts get more and more cloudy. Shh, I like your kind better when they don't talk. Her visage morphs, revealing hideous characteristics as she pulls your head back, exposing your neck. The fear and adrenaline gives you an edge for thought. You gotta act quickly and reach for your weapon. This is an encounter. You are able to reach your weapon. With a swift movement, you swing it with killing intention towards the siren. She dodges the attack, but the attack was enough to create some distance between you and your foe. The weight on your body lifts and you are able to move again. The face of the siren contorts more and the screech directed at you escapes the mouth. Let's fight! Hello, Merok. Level 6. Oh, this is kind of a small boss. Okay, no problem. And now sleep. What does it do? Merge is nice as I have two of them. If I use one, I will use both of the cards. Target non-undead, it is not an undead, synergy, vulnerable, plus 2, and stun, and more concealment. So yes, please. Now, it means it will be affected every turn by that, but... Oh, it's not immune, but the action potential is too low to affect it. Okay, it was useless, so let's just make her bleed. Ah, bleed also. It is, well, 16. Is way too much powerful for my potential, so I will just have to make damage. Resist 5 piercing. Oh, target resist 5, but I did 21. Why that? Oh, silver was effective against her. That's nice to know. Enter. Eesh. What the? I had enough defense. That's nice. Spirit Bane. Is it a spirit? No, it is a monster assassin wildlife. Blessed, I do piercing damage. Target practice. I will get retribution when you will be attacking me. Retribution doesn't care about resistances and shields, so my retribution should be U. Why didn't I get retribution? Ah, I don't have a companion. Come on. I killed it at last. I know it's a reaction, I have to use it now or lose it. Okay, so let's use it. I lost a card and now I have focus plus one. What are though their resistances? It has resistances. So I'll try to kill her first. And I have the blade first. Silver is nice against Crypt Crawler. Oh, he isn't affected by silver. Sniff. I can't unleash it because I have no companion. But maybe I will have one the next turn. So you will keep the card. And none. So let's. And now you sleep, I said. Sleep. Hunter's Brew. More damage and double. Earth, she has no two earth resistance. I can wait one turn because she has the stun. She won't do anything. And now I can use everything I have to kill her. Let's continue. Oh, damage plus four. Very nice. Come on, and the bleeding, 1 HP per bleeding status, it won't be enough to kill her, so the dagger should be enough to finish him, to finish her. Hunter's Brew, and now this card will do damage. Come on, yes, it's enough. Let's continue. Nice, a chest. Silver dagger, enlightenment, more XP and more draw. That's nice. Let's get it in the hand. Alchemist bomb, holy water, and acid. Why not? Acid is good. Let's put it in the stash. So I want to learn a new technique to use 10 AP ethereal from item 1 concealment. I don't know what. Oh, 8! It's very expensive. It's too expensive for me. Silversmith, craft one silver coating. That means fleeting. Oh, if I keep it, it didn't. Okay, I must use it or I lost. Range. Ah, I need more range. Morph means once it will get to level 3, and will get amplified piercing 1. More piercing damage, chance to receive a copy of this action. Whoa, very nice. Into my deck, please. So do I need rest? Oh, not that much. I got 9 AP per turn. Okay. Continue. Well, I don't know why I do get more AP. I had only 8. I don't know what gives me more AP better. Continue. So let's use it to get more experience. And it as it has an echo, it will then one more time. Echo 2 on here. Tripwire. Ah, they are both stunned. Let's use everything to get more XP. Ah, but where is my companion? I have to unleash it. It's useless. I will use it to get more XP. So target practice. Not enough. then hide from view. Make her bleed. It's not enough, come on. Yes. What will we learn? Venison. It's nice to reactivate companion alive. It's very good that to make them act twice. This one too, but I discard a card. It's not really nice, in fact. This is on the companion on an ally, meaning I can't use Venison on an ally because it's only on an Imals, for instance. Range, double, piercing, simple, effective, ethereal strike, split astral, expand aether. I need aether, soul of the fate, focus. I craft a new ethereal strike. Oh, that can be nice. Vulnerable 2 and air damage. How much air damage do I do? Air plus 3! Whoa! Let's take it and see how it fares. If it's useful or not. And we are nice as the next boss. They are stunned and I will try to kill him. Let's use a steel mine. Natural remedy. To get more XP. Even if it's a bit useless for now. The bleed isn't enough. And he healed himself. Okay, first hide. Then camouflage. Oh, he didn't bleed? Why that? He's immune to this effect. Oh, he can't never bleed. Whoa, you can see there he has a lot of abilities. Sneak attack, bewitch, bleeding and venom, vulnerable, kill and drain. Whoa. Lot of resistances. I need to kill him with just my weapons. He flank me, doesn't do anything to me. So Entangle will have a half a chance to make him miss his turn. It's not as good as Immobilize, but some cards use the Entangle effect to add more things. Make him bleed, make him kill. That's better. So let's use the no. I have no more enemies to fight. Oh, a lot of resistances. Let's kill the first the small ones. And then desecrate. What does it do? Enemy forgoes a melee attack in retribution damage. During the end of turn effect phase, the Aura of Darkness will harm all living and heal all undead and demonic entities. Uh-oh. Okay. And now you sleep, but he is in... it's too low. He's 13. That's way too much power for me. Yes! My animal companion. Come here, boy. As you can see there, how much turn it will he will stay with me, it is forever, there are no turns. You can use it in two ways, you can make him attack, he will do damage and receive the damage, so if I do that, he will die, which is, well, not a great idea. Or I can use it on my card, or just click there, to get his special abilities to be tracked. So I will get more damage, if the enemy has a lot of rage, I get concealment and I have animal bane instead, but this one is not an animal, but he's wicked. I am something for the wicked. No shield, penetrate, venom, penetrate adds to be able to overcome their power. So just amplify piercing first. And yes, silver was nice. If you can see, silver, silver, silver. Bleed phase, but silver, yes, twice as much damage. Silver is nice against weak creatures. Ouch! Five retribution damage. Okay, he has a spiked armor. I can't resist that. How much will do one damage to me? So first I will heal. I will track him and must kill him this turn. Target practice and let's finish him with my silver weapon. I level up soon, yes, as you can see. And continue. Ah, I would have needed this the turn before. This is the last line for this run. I'm a bit okay. More health, please. I could have used it on my companion. Oh, it's useless. I have no one. Priestess of the Crimson Flame. Okay. Why didn't I heal? Because of the synergy damage. As you can see, you must be careful because the synergy damage gave me more damage. But as I use the card on my companion, it does the damage on my companion. Come on, I forgot that. Okay. I can shun her. That's bad news. No. She couldn't resist my piercing attack. Dazzling shot. Stun. Nice. Penetrate plus one. Penetrate plus two. Bleed. And dispel shield. Oh. It can be nice. Pining shot. Bleed. And piercing bleed can be nice, but it's not that useful. But the stun effect is very, very good. Oh, I got a new level. Maybe I got new cards. Natural instinct. Flage, perfect ambush. I didn't put some of the tone. I got Aether. Now I have cards that use Aether. So let's add them. I have a lot of cards now. I must be careful to not add too many. First track, then now. Level up, yes! Perk points! Otherworldly charisma, more astral damage, hated reflex, more agility, more AP, yes! Good, I like that. Agility is good. What will I get? More poison damage, action points, more action points, please! I want more action points. Oh, I didn't use them on the last. Okay, intellectual, vigilant, range weapons training, come on, yes, intellectual or tough, I want to be tough, let's be tough. Maybe new cards, barbed wire traps, multicast, bleed and retribution, I like you. Eagle Sight, Synergy Damage, Amplify Piercing, very good. What did damage? I will get some cards out. Synergy synergy damage, single the fae, amplified piercing. Song of the Fae for now, Song of the Fae is a bit useless. So I will get them out finally. I will use them. So 42 is still a lot of cards. I don't need so much unleash, only one once I will have it. Wolfbane Venom. Synergy damage entangle. Not that useful finally. Blade thrust, I need to do damage and silver damage. Amplify piercing, that can be very, very good. Okay. Let's start with the target practice. Not bad, not bad. Let's put him to sleep. Oh no, he resisted. He resisted stun. I wasn't strong enough. No problem. Let's use a remedy on my animal companion. Target practice. And this on myself and continue. Oh, there will be a settlement there. Chain Vampire. Touches inhuman even when directed to a monster. Yes, I think that. I lost some order but got some karma and I got some experience. I got new skills. Yes. But first, as you can see there, I have order less 2, karma plus 2. Some events will happen if I have karma and order. It's like the alignment in Dungeons and Dragons. Am I a neutral character or a lawful or a chaotic one? And karma is more, am I good or evil or neutral? Visit the town. Okay. So first, sell the equipment I don't use to get more farthings. I don't need all of this. Thank you very much. So weapons and shielding. There's some interesting things. Sneak attack, yes. That's good. Amplified piercing doubles. If I have concealment, I make them... Whoa. This one is very nice, but too expensive for me. I could click once more and see the daytime advance to try to have something else. Let's... Whoa, 2 hours! Range double, piercing, blood tribute, quick draw. I still don't know what means blood tribute. I don't know what it means. Oh, I don't have enough to buy it. Let's see if I can buy allies. A stone totem. You can see how many turns they will stay with you when you summon them. Whenever he deals damage, range is never good. Nice agents. Cool skirmish. That's nice. Impaired. Combat damage deal 2 to 5 earth damage. That's nice too. But they don't have a lot of hit points. 7, 5. Vampire Hunter is nice. But why are they so expensive? Sticky net trap. No thanks. Oh, it summons an ally. A sticky net trap is an ally. Hingy. Oh, when she leaves plate and tangles everyone. Nice. Okay. I have enough for her. Grove warding. Come with me, please. So now. Okay, it's already added into my deck. 40 cards is a nice number for a deck. Let's leave town. I have everything I need. Let's camouflage Spirit Bane on this enemy. Plus 4 intense, yes. Coven Spell Binder because it is a Whipped or Vampire, I don't know which one triggered the Bane. Steel Mind and Amplify Piercing. Let's kill her. And track. When you use the special abilities of your animals, you can see there that he has already 5 XP. The more you use them, the more effective it will be. Ah yes, Unleash. Finally! Now I have the next thing I will do will get me 4 retribution. I will do damage to him if he attacks me, but I will kill him first. It's faster. And I will heal my companion. Archer's Instinct, nice. Oh. A chest. More AP. Resist Water, Synergy, Freeze, plus 1. No. A treasure map. Let's take it in the hand. And this one too. If I go there, we have a lot of new things, but no, I want to show you the end of the run. As you pass through a small settlement, your eye is caught by an angry mob surrounding a poorly dressed hermit. They seem to accuse him of heresy and practicing witchcraft. Please help me, I haven't done anything wrong, he pleads as you approach closer. A man dressed in steel plate and bearing the Inquisition insignia interrupts him. Silence! That's for me to decide, peasant. As for you, stranger, I would strongly recommend moving on. He adds with a glare. Really, I would strongly recommend to leave this man alone. The Inquisitor simply waves to his squire and along with his underlings approach with their intention to arrest you, apparent. So less order, more karma, and some XP. Let's fight. These are low level. They are not that strong, so let's first hide from you. Hey, hey, I'm not there. Where am I? Not there. So, synergy damage. And let's attack the weakest one. Oh, come on, 1 HP. Are you serious? Let's use the Hunter Brew. It won't kill him. Okay. That's it. What do I have in my backpack? Alchemist bomb. Let's use it. So as you can see, I've drawn it and I can use it. Penetrate, Echo, Venom 3. We will get Venom. Let's kill him. So Venom is very good. It's better than Bleed because Venom does 3 HP of damage per turn. Enter. Ah, come on. He has a shield. Okay, no problem. I don't care. I will just hit you with enough power to overcome your shield. Ah, I should have used it before. I'm stupid. What is this one? Benefactor. To all allies, he has no more allies. So first, let's track him. Then a dagger, then my short spear. And now move on. Let's use the treasure map. Stack digging. This is the correct spot. Oh, Ring of Chaos. That is ceremonial pipe. Target self, lose HP, lose fatigue. Oh, that's good when you have a lot of cards to play. Discount 2 but restore 10 HP. No thanks. Pekka input, so I'm gonna take this to sell it. And the settlement and the coin pouch. Let's take it in the hand. Continue. You don't look so dignified now, covering your blood. Is that pure smell? You ask the Inquisitor, picking his silver sword from the ground. Please, I have a family, he starts to beg. My son is only 3. Ah, come on. Become a farmer, man. Oh, silver sword. Nice, but not that good. A trinket. Healing plus 5. Craft herbal infusion. Please, I want this trinket. Please, 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 let's put it in the deck. As you can see, my wolf leveled up, he has more HP. Let's visit the town. So first, sell the equipment I don't need. Yes, a lot of farthings. Oh, I don't have that much, finally. Allies, those are too costly to consumables. Vampire Bane. Let's take the Dead Man's Coin. Gain XP and draw. Okay. Let's buy that and the Alchemist Bomb. It can be nice. But do I have enough provisions? Okay, I have to. Let's leave town. What does. Oh! I use it too fast. I don't know what it does. It does the Gambit. Let's learn a new combat technique. Mischief. Neither one. Gambit. Song of the Fae 2 plus Clairvoyance 2. Oh! That's nice. But I need Song of the Fae. Venison is nice. Or the Bolt to get more damage. Let's get the Bolt on the deck. Let's set up camp because. Dead Man's Coin Gambit. What does Gambit? Let's search Gambit. Please. Okay. There is another way, but I don't remember how. Oh, I'll search another time. For now, let's look at what we have. A Coven Spell Bion, a Threat Sorceress, and a Crypt Crawler. Undead Wicked, Fledgling Vampire Wicked, Human Elzar. Let's first stun them. We hide from view. Let's use our dagger, then our shots. Oh! Long knife or bandage. Let's put in the stash. And turn. They are stunned, so they do nothing. Let's use the tripwire one more time, because yes. Let's use camouflage, then the dagger. In turn. Why can't I use it? I don't have enough either. Okay. Oh, action failed. Oh. Okay, I lost the card. No problem. No problem at all. I'm very happy. Continue. Okay, Lincoln Skirmisher, sneak attack, immunity, sneak attack, immobilize, bewitch, vulnerable, frozen. Whoa. I need more power. But no, immune to sleep. Okay. So let's use the dagger first, fish or spear, and enter. Okay, camouflage, dagger, short spear. Thank you. What will I learn? Oh, armor piercing. That's powerful. It dispels shield and adds bleed. Impaired, vulnerable and weakened. Impaired can be nice. Vulnerable will add damage when they are hit. And it's very good. So first, enter brew with the dagger, the short spear, and the amulet. Ah, I should have used the track first. Let's use the track first. Go hunt. Teamwork. Exhaust and active life. You do the next action. Place this tank in synergy coding plus 4. Okay. Let's train. Power plus 1, max health plus 2. Please! Be more powerful. No. More power and more HP. Tiger, fish and spear. And let's heal him. Let's use the flashback. First, the dagger. Oh, eagle sight, nice. Yes! A copy of the card. Very good. Oh. Yes, once again. I love this card. Oh, it did nothing? Why? Oh no, it did nothing. I'm stupid. Oh, it did a lot of damage. Wow, the eagle eye is very, very strong. So, empower 1, heal 9 HP. So, for me, thanks. Hunter Brew, Fish of Spear. Let's use Exceed of the Blade and this. So, I have a full hand on the next turn. Oh, I killed her already. And this is the end or a new beginning. I can now reincarnate. And once you reincarnate, come on, please. Yes, I wait. Book of Heroes. As you can see, my human shadow level 7 there. I can continue to play her in another mode, and I can continue with her in normal mode or adventure, or I can choose any mode I like and continue the adventure with this character. And when they die, they come here and I can spend tokens to revive them and reuse them in a new adventure. I hope you liked it. This game is really interesting because there are so many possibilities. It's very, very, very nice. For now it was very quick. But when you do a more longer run, you have more cards and you can switch to the kind of damage you can do and how you play, or what kind of, for instance, the Aether, you could be using this to a different kind of play for different enemies. So this is all for now, and I hope you like this video. And Vyosha out!